Hello, my name is Benjamin Eaton. I'm the National Marketing Manager here at Petzl America, and I am with Christian Knight, the National Sales Manager at Petzl America. We are launching a new belay device called the NEOX, and we'd like to talk to you about the device itself and how it fits into the range of Petzl's canvas-assisted blocking devices.
Our goal with the NEOX was to provide what the GRIGRI can offer, but a more seamless belay experience that you're going to have with a traditional belay device, you know, something that doesn't have cam-assisted blocking. They're known for feeding slack very easily to a leader, and there's no real special techniques to defeat the cam or anything like that. So the NEOX does a really good job of balancing both of those benefits into one device.
Let's help everyone understand how we got to this before we dive even deeper on the NEOX. 1991 is when the original GRIGRI was launched. This changed the way that we belay and what belay devices can do with introducing cam-assisted blocking to the industry of climbing. In 2011, then we came out with the updated version of the GRIGRI, scaling down its footprint, just a lighter and smaller device, accommodating a lot of the thinner ropes that were coming to market around that time. And then in 2017 came the GRIGRI Plus. The GRIGRI Plus, the plus in the name alludes to the fact that there are some additional features, an additional steel wear plate, you have a belay mode selector. And then the third feature is the anti-panic handle. 2019, we launched the current version of the GRIGRI. The changes that we made on here kind of did some recalibrations on the attachment hole. We played a little bit around with the angles here to provide better progressive descent control. And then overall just made sure that the GRIGRI itself was able to accommodate even thinner ropes, so allowing both devices that are currently on the market to accommodate the 8.5 millimeter to 11 millimeter range. And then that takes us to 2024, where now we are launching the NEOX. One thing to point out though, is that in the pedigree of the NEOX and the GRIGRI, the family tree of it all branches off into the industrial world. You have all sorts of devices now. The ID, the Maestro, the firefighters using the XOAP. Yep. It's just amazing to see how the original GRIGRI just started this chain effect, this ripple effect in the climbing realm, but also in the professional realm now. And now we're, you know, advancing, or I guess spreading that family tree with an additional branch that's now introducing this internal wheel that provides a smoother experience for the user. One of the questions that I've had as I've shown this to some people is just like, it looks like a GRIGRI. You named it differently, but you made it look the same. The truth is, yes, it's still a GRIGRI to the extent that it still holds the family characteristics. Yeah. And what would those be? Like, in what ways are these still the same?
We've kind of kept that overall form factor the same. The ergonomics, the feel.
The way that they capture the rope is all the same. It's still an internal cam that is going to be pinching that rope. Even with the spinning wheel, you still see that the cam will pivot and pinch the rope, which is really nice because there's no huge learning curve. If you're jumping from a GRIGRI or GRIGRI Plus to a NEOX, and I would even say that because of this wheel, you can use the NEOX with traditional belay techniques as if you were using a manual braking tubular device. Yep. And you're going to get that fluid, smooth experience.
That was one of the goals with this device, was very rarely are you having to touch the NEOX to do anything special to pay out the slack. It's a really nice experience for people that are learning and that are getting into leading. And they have all the advantages of, you know, catching the falls. It's a little bit more convenient. And then obviously holding a resting climber is a little bit nicer as well, because you can do it with your body weight.
We've seen other companies come out with their versions of a cam-assisted blocking device, and they're trying different form factors and things, but in the end, you know, this is the gold standard, and just adding additional features onto an ideal setup already, like adding the features of the GRIGRI Plus or adding the wheel of the NEOX.
Yeah, I'd say everything's fairly well sorted. We could make it smaller and lighter, but if you make it too small, it's finicky to work with in your hands. We could, you know, remove parts of the housing to make it, you know, slightly less friction in there and things like that. But then again, your skin and other pieces of equipment can get caught up in the rope or burn your hand. So we feel like this is the ideal form factor for a belay device.
You mentioned about making it bigger or smaller. That's a kind of a good segue into some of the differences between it. So in terms of the weight comparison, 235 grams with the NEOX, 200 grams with the GRIGRI Plus, and the GRIGRI stands at 175. Price-wise, you're the salesman. What's the price difference in the three devices?
At $139.95, a GRIGRI Plus is a worthy investment. We've got the GRIGRI $109.95, excellent price point, and then $149.95 for that NEOX.
So we get a lot of questions on like, well, what causes this wheel to stop spinning?
It's not a centrifugal locking mechanism that causes the wheel to stop. It's a very simplified mechanism, and this wheel moves back and forth. So once you put input onto that brake strand, it's going to slide that wheel into the second position. At that point, it stops turning, and then the whole thing just behaves like a normal cam-assisted locking device.
The device just needs tension in the brake strand. If that's what starts pushing that wheel off its axis. With any belay device that's on the market, they're not hands-free devices. They function when you are diligently maintaining the brake strand.
Correct.
And I guess while we're also talking on some do's and don'ts, one thing that we should mention is the fact that the NEOX is a device for a belayer to belay another climber.
Correct.
It is not a device that has been made for self-belaying. Now that we have three devices on the market that are cam-assisted blocking, people are going to wonder, well, which device is right for me? And the best advice that I have for people is focus on the what and not the who. Now, all three devices can do both top roping and lead belaying, but let's dive into some of those idiosyncrasies of each one.
Sure.
That helps justify why we would say this is optimized for top, this maintains its good use for both, and this is for lead.
A lot of times we see the GRIGRI Plus in like the hands of a guide or an instructor at an institution that's going to be teaching people how to climb and belay for their very first time on their very first day. If we're in top rope mode here, we have a lot less tension in the spring on that cam. So when the climber falls, it's gonna pull that cam really quickly and engage on the rope and prevent any, you know, unnecessary slippage in the system. So a new insecure climber that, you know, isn't as confident with the rope systems, that's a bit more reassuring.
But the GRIGRI, you know, we're saying that it maintains its good versatile abilities in both top rope and lead. And I would like to even go beyond that and say single to multi-pitch. It's smaller, it's lighter, it's yep. going to be better racked up on your harness. But overall, you know, it has that classic spring tension that we're all used to.
I mean, it does, it works for everything very well. But like you said, I think there's plenty of people using it in a multi-pitch scenario and they want something lighter weight, more compact. Maybe something that has a bit more friction in it for rappelling or keeping the rope engaged and locked when they're bringing up a second climber.
And then we got the NEOX. Obviously, we're saying that this is optimized for lead belaying, obviously, because you can smoothly pass the rope through the device using traditional belay techniques, and you're just going to have a very fluid experience. There's a lot of people that are experiencing tendonitis of shoulders and elbows because it's just like multiple hours on hours of belaying, and that's where this is going to really come in clutch. I think it's very impressive that Petzl now has three cam-assisted blocking devices on the market. I mean, the GRIGRI is the gold standard for good reasons. It started the whole concept back in 1991, and it has maintained its position as the gold standard. Regardless of what devices come out, people ask, which GRIGRI is that? You know, it's the Band-Aid of belay devices, the Xerox, the Jell-O of belay devices, to where all other devices are compared to it. But as it maintains its position as the king of the hill, Petzl has two other devices that are very similar in many ways, but optimized for some other specialized uses, and to where you have this trifecta, you know, maintaining that position in the market that all other devices are pretty much compared to. And when other devices come out, it's always a quick debate on, well, how does it compare to the GRIGRI? And it comes down to personal preference on, you know, which device is ideal for you. And it's a matter of getting your hands on one, test driving it, and finding out which features are suitable for you, for what you're doing. Again, focus on the what, not necessarily the who, when you're trying to determine which device is right for you or for a friend when they're asking you for your recommendations.
Ultimately, there's a GRIGRI for everyone, or in this case, a NEOX.